Board. Board.
Why don't you go on the slide then?
All right, in.
Oh, thanks.
Hey, a ski slide, out of the way! All right, give me my ball back!
Hey, hey, hands, come back! You don't know how to skateboard! Never gonna catch it. Hey, wait! They're by your board, please.
Help!
Friends, something to do. It was good fun. Way to get around. What it started off as, transport. So now it's what I want to do all the time. I just want to skate, because I get to travel when I skate, go places, do things.
If a girl wants to skateboard, then she can. Like the others always tell me to do stuff and that, they never sort of say, oh, you can't do it because you're a girl. Where you meet with different people and stuff like that, and you go to different parks and things, and just sort of stay in the same place and everything. And in the street skating, we don't even have to go to the park and that. We can do that anywhere.
How am I ever going to get Angelo back?
Oh no! No!
Wait!
How do we stop these things? Where are the brakes?
Angelo's gone off your board and I've lost Angelo. How are we going to get him back? We'll never catch him on foot.
About this board?
Oh, great! Skateboarding! Yeah, we'll chase him on these, yeah?
Yeah, well before we try anything, put these on.
Put these on?
Yeah. Calm down, slow down.
Right. Right. Okay, now I've got the pads on. Now, The next thing is just to go, yeah?
Well, yeah. But you've got to learn how to do it first.
Okay, right. So, something like that.
No, not quite. Hold on.
Is that... Right.
Right, the first thing you do is you've got to keep your weight over the middle of the board.
Over here?
So put your front foot on first there.
On there?
Yeah.
Yeah.
And then as you push off with your back foot and put your back foot on the tail, keeping your weight over the centre of the board. Now push. That's it.
I'm not going very fast,
I know,
though.
You've got to push, haven't you?
Oh, right.
All right, so take off. Now push. There you go.
There's a wall!
Ah!
Well, about 3 months ago, got a cheap skateboard, put it together, and I enjoyed it, so got a new one. Just kept on from there. Mainly street, walls, just anything original. There's nothing. There's no specifications, you just go out and do a trick what you want. Doesn't matter, as long as it's fun. It's okay.
Oh, that's better, thanks.
What are you doing?
What are these things?
They're skateboards. Do you want to know the story of skateboarding?
Yeah.
Come with me.
Right. Bring this.
The vicious history of skateboarding, take two. Ah, a skateboard. Now, these haven't been around an awful lot of time. You see, what happened was, there was once a surfer who, due to a lack of wind, decided to take up roller skating, but there wasn't much you could do on roller skates, really. I mean, what can you do on roller skates?
You can go up and down like this guy behind us, but not much.
Sometimes some
yeah.
people will
anyway he lost one of his roller skates and there it goes and needing something to travel around on, he decided to nail a bit of wood onto the skate that was left, thus inventing the skateboard. His name was...
The man's name was Jeremy Skateboard.
Best at half-pipe riding. I'm better, not good, but better at half-pipe riding than other sports like street or if you're high, it feels nice when you're up high and things like that, or freaky when you're dropping in.
Okay, here we go.
You jumped on it.
If you want to have a go at skateboarding, ring 01 222 8070 now. That's 01 222 8070 now.
Wait,
jump down, shoot out
from underneath you. Stepping, okay.
Right, so you
go.
Step.
Step.
Okay. So pull it back up. As he comes by, you put your front foot on the way down your back foot. That was it. You were on there.
Nearly moved.
No, a better trick than that.
It's the invention of Jeremy Skateboard, so never get off the ground, will it?
What, skateboard?
Have a go at skateboarding. Ring 01 222 8070. That's 01 222 8070. Now.
Sean first, who we met earlier.
Hi, I'm John.
He's one of the top street skaters.
So what is it you're looking for?
See, and Sean?
I'll be looking for difficulty of manoeuvres, perform the height, and just general difficulty.
Okay, let's have a look at the first of our skaters.
So Sean, here we are watching Barry for England. Tell me about the board that you need. Do you need a special one for the half pipe?
You see the board is right, it's wider than the old board from Craig's days. It's adequate balance now. It's basically easier.
Yeah. And how much would you expect to pay for one of these boards?
You expect to pay for a top class board around £150.
That's quite a lot of money.
Right, next up we have representing Wales on the half pipe. It's Chris. Don? Tell me a bit about what he's trying to do here.
Well, he's just fallen off the frontside balance, but now he's getting up speed to start his routine. You basically got to keep up a lot of speed. He's gone into an axle stalk,
oh,
but he's wiped out, so...
Not having a lot of luck, is he?
Next skater, Dave Phillips. He's got... There was a rock and roll slide, tail slide, another tail slide. He goes into...
Now, what about protective clothing, Sean?
When they're falling, you see they're falling onto their knees. Usually you wear two pairs of knee pads, which works out expensive because they're around £30 a pair. But you have to wear protective clothing, otherwise you can fall really badly.
Do you reckon you're going to do yourself permanent damage with your knee?
I myself received an injury to the knee at the European Championships this weekend, so I can't skate that well. But in the long run, you may get permanent damage. Well, it's just the same as football, so you get kicked in the shins, you can get permanent damage in the shins. So much to take.
Dangerous.
Okay, finally we have Bob representing Ireland, getting off to a pretty sticky start there again, wasn't he?
Yeah.
Nice and high. Look at the... What about the general standard of this competition?
Well, it's amongst the best when they stay on, but, you know, the pressure, the cameras and that.
Yes. Not as easy as it looks. A nice.
Well done, Sue. That's great. Sue's going to be one of our judges in our competition now, along with Don. And it's the 16 and under street style competition. We've got representatives from Scotland, from Wales, and from England. No one, however, from Ireland, because apparently it hasn't taken off there yet. So Ireland, get your skates on. Our first representative to go, 15-year-old Nick Johnston. Nick's from Dundee. He started skating about 6 months ago. Got his first skateboard around about Christmas time. Gets all his gear and his equipment from a local shop. They actually give it to him and he manages to pay for it later, so he's worked a good deal with them. Off goes Nick from Scotland. Next we have from Wales, Jason Williams. Jason's actually from Swansea. He's aged 16. And a few friends of Jason's, a while ago, built their own half pipe just outside his house. And apparently neighbours complained so much they had to bring it down because there was no planning permission. Thank you, Jason. Off you come. And the next and final competitor today is Grant Proctor from England, aged 15. A nice smile from Grant. Likes to be called Yogi. 15 years of age, as I said. He's been skating about 4 months. Now, he got the idea from BMX magazines when he saw top BMXers started skateboarding. He thought he'd jump on the bandwagon or jump on the skateboard, as it were. He saved up money from his paper round to buy his board. Doing quite well today. Nearly went there, didn't he? There you go. Thank you, Yogi. Off you go.
Well, now for the exciting bit, the results of the competition. But before we get those, let's ask Don what he thought about the standard. Don, what did you think about the standard?
Well, I thought it was very good. Some of the stuff that was being done, like bone-ups and wall walks, were pretty good stuff. So we're doing good.
Does it look good for British skateboarding in general, then?
Yeah, very good.
Good as the Americans?
Not quite that good, but, you know, we're getting there.
Good. Okay. Well, I think Nino's got... Have you got the prizes, Nino?
Yeah.
Sue, you've got the results, I think, haven't you? Prizes
right.
Here. Okay. Well, what have we got here?
Got third place, Nick Johnson from Scotland. The mark's out of 100, and he's got 65.
65 for Nick Johnson.
Over here, Kel.
Well done, Nick.
There you go. There's a video. There's some shorts for you as well, and well done.
Well done. Okay. Right, second.
Second place, we've got Jason Williams from Wales with 75 points.
Jason Williams, hey. Well done.
Jason, once again for you, you get the video. Some t-shirts.
No cuddly toy.
No cuddly toy. They got the cuddly toys that you asked for 10 minutes ago.
So by process of elimination, I think we know the winner, don't we?
This leaves Yogi from England, and he's got 80 points.
80 points, well done.
Have a look. There's a helmet for safety reasons. Turn around, let's see, have a look. There's that for you as well. Come around here.
Safety pads.
Ready, put the badges as well. We'll put those in your helmet. All right, oops, all
we
over
want
the floor.
All those, all over
there's
the floor.
All this. Fancy skateboard.
Yeah, thanks.
Well done.
Well done.
Right.
Terrific.
Okay, that's... Can't believe
he's
it.
He's laden down now.
That's just about it for this week.
Thank you, Sue.
Next week, Owen Paul in the studio.
And we'll also be introducing you to a whole load of creepy crawlies. Don't mean Nino.
Thanks.
Not this time. Right. See you next week.
Bye.
Bye.